Hello everybody, welcome back to the video. I'm Purple Elf and Gaming here, and today we're playing some more BattdBloonsAdventure on Power Defense. Today, I'm doing a video that I knew I could have done for a long time, but I never really wanted to do it, and there's a couple of reasons. So basically, this video, as I'm sure you know from the title, but whatever, we're looking at wish orb farming, which is a very important part of the game, more so the late, mid to end game, but still, it's a very important part of the game. And the reason I didn't make a video on this sooner, because this is a very important topic and thing that if you play this game and you intend to reach all the way to the end, you really, at the very least, need to know about it, but probably should be doing it to a decent degree as well. For certain stages of the game, this is very crucial. But the reason I didn't is because when I was first starting off, it was a pretty easy topic to find quite a bit of information on, and it was fairly self-explanatory. However, looking back at it, thinking it over a little bit more, you did ask for it. A couple people have asked for it. In the past, I was a little iffy, but as people keep asking for it, I figured, you know what, I'll do it. There's no real harm. But there also isn't exactly an in-depth video guide. There is definitely a lot of information in the wiki and stuff, but there isn't necessarily a good video for it. So that's what I'm here for, helping you all out for. Plus, I have a feeling I can do a fairly decent job. And I know a lot of you guys that do watch me do research on the wiki and stuff, but some of you don't, so, you know, anyways. So basically, wish orb farming centralizes around this little weapon here, the Thought Cannon Wand, arguably the best item in the entire game. Mobs hit by most attacks drop loot when destroyed. It's really, really, really good. Basically, she attacks the mob dies, it spawns loot. And although that is usually just money or lives, which the lives are almost always entirely useless, a decent chunk of the time, it's wish orbs. Of all varieties, it can even be straight up epic wish orbs. It's pretty rare, I'm not gonna lie. It's only happened to me like 2 or 3 times back when I was doing more serious wish orb farming. But I mean, it still does happen, and it's definitely still a fairly, like, it's a big deal when you get an epic wish orb out of that. And even if you don't get an epic, you can easily get many, like tens of commons and uncommons. There is a max of 30 per game, is one thing I will say. It usually isn't that big of an issue, but it's more so if you were doing this in motion games, just be wary there is a cap of 30. The one thing that bothers me, I understand it, it's probably hard to implement, but it does bother me a little bit. Something to keep in mind is, once you reach that limit, that's it. They're not going to be like, hey, well, let's spawn a super rare and we'll replace your common with a super rare. If you reach 30, it's just not going to spawn them anymore. That's one thing to keep in mind. So Thought Cannon Wand is definitely the main impact. Flame Princess is who you want to equip it to because she is the strongest DPS of the 3 magic wielding towers. And that's basically the key part of this. You want Flame Princess to be doing as much of your damage as possible. The secondary item for this is the treasure chest keys. Mobs pop by the equipped character have a small chance of dropping a chest with all kinds of loot in it. So, treasure chest keys, there's a bit of a difference. Actually, it's a fairly big difference that I wasn't quite aware of when I first read these descriptions. So, treasure chest keys, the character has to get the last shot on a Moab. For the Thought Cannon Wand, it only has to have hit the Moab before it dies. It's a pretty significant difference, meaning you're a lot more likely to get the Thought Cannon item than treasure chest key. It's also a much rarer drop chance. However, the one thing about the treasure chest keys is, although it can give you wish orbs, it's a very small number. But the main thing it can give you is, it does not give you in-game cash, it gives you out-of-game coins and gems. So, I'm not entirely sure if this is true, but from my experience, it seems to be that you can only get one gem chest per game, and you can get infinite coin and wish orb, but obviously there's the 30 wish orb limit, so eventually it'll reach a point where it is exclusively coins. Which isn't a bad thing, it's definitely a good thing. Treasure chest keys are very useful, not as good as Thought Cannon Wand for wish orbs, but they are really, a lot of you guys constantly ask me, hey, how do you get so many gems? I rarely ever mention this one, but if you're just straight up farming, and you're going to be doing the other methods that I recommend, it's good. It'll give you an extra, if you get lucky enough, it can give you an extra 20, 30 gems per game. It's a big deal. So you definitely want to equip it. It does stack with Thought Cannon Wand as well, so you definitely want to use it as well. The rest of this, we're just giving her good upgrades, so Fire Crown for the attack speed upgrade, Baker Shard, 50% attack speed, Demon Heart, 2 damage, Heart Gauntlets, Engineer Blueprint, Guru Meter, Cosmic Gauntlets, all that stuff. Basically, you want to give her as much attack speed and as much damage as possible with your limits. Treasure Chest Keys is important, Thought Cannon Wand is important, the rest You just want to make her as strong as possible. If you have a level 3, though I mean, I doubt you'll have a Thought Can wand with a level 3 Flame Princess, but if you do, then you can do Treasure Chest Keys, Thought Can wand, and whatever your strongest trinkets are. As peer advice, I'd probably say, in this case, since you don't have a weapon that gives damage, Demon Heart's probably first priority, so damage is first, attack speed would be secondary priority. Don't value range. Thought Cannon 1 gives like 12 range. It's not important. But yeah, that's basically what you want to do for Flame Princess. The other character I'm going to use for the strategy is... No, wrong. Didn't mean to go there. Is Super Monkey. So, there's a couple reasons why I'm picking Super Monkey. First of all, for most players, for the majority of the game, he is going to be your best sheer pop owl. Especially once you have a camera detection trinket. He's basically it. He works really well. The second you do that, it works. Personally, I'd probably prefer Psy if I was pure grinding, since it requires less effort. But you need much better gear for Psy to work. You need a lot worse gear for Super Monkey. So I'm going to recommend Super Monkey. The second thing with him is, once again, Treasure Chest Keys. In this current setup, for Treasure Chest Keys, if you only have one, which most people probably do, who do you get it on? That's a good question. It's a little dependent. If you're strong enough that Flame Princess is doing most of the damage, give it to Flame Princess. If Super Monkey is doing most of the damage, give it to Super Monkey. That's basically what I'm saying. Obviously, in my case, I have two. I can give one to both. It's the best case scenario. Beyond that, same thing as before. Make him as strong as possible. I equipped the Future Crystal, which helps both of them, so that's always nice. The one thing I will say, because this is from experience, do not give either character Crystal Apple. Or Emergence of Destruction. So, Emergence of Destruction, the sandwich, the crystal sandwich thing, it does not work with Treasure Chest Keys or Thought Can 1. If you have it, you will get nothing. Do not use it if you're farming Wish Orbs. This is a very obvious thing. The secondary thing is that the Crystal Apple, it still works, but it makes it a little iffy, and it makes it a lot less likely that Flame Princess is going to be... Trust me, it's just a bit of a hassle. It causes issues. It's better not to use it. But that's pretty much it. You just want to make them as strong as possible. The one thing I will say, if you have him, Monkey Farmer. I'm using him in this strategy because I did this before I had Monkey Farmer, and my fingers hurt, and so much patience and attention. It's a lot harder. So Monkey Farmer, just harvests the item drops automatically. Otherwise, you have to like hover your finger over them, or mouse, or whatever, and tap them, and... click them. It's just a hassle. I'm using him. If you have him, definitely use him. We're actually going to be doing this on Crown Capes because I want an Impopple Medal, and I'm using an OP Super Monkey and an OP Flame Princess with Thought Can 1, which I will admit gives an insane amount of in-game cash. This should be pretty easy. Okay, so because, honestly, why not? We're going to be starting with Flame Princess. The one thing I will do with my current thing is I'm going to be getting my Cobras because, well, I mean, money-making... Is it necessary in the slightest for the strategy? Nope. But do I want it anyways? I do, because, you know what? Just in case, it's a good idea to have. And although, for me, my stage of the game is pretty easy. Having the money is never a bad idea. And although, like I said, Thought Can 1 will make you a lot of money. It needs mobs to do that. It doesn't work on normal balloons, in case that wasn't entirely obvious. It only works on mobs, both of these things. Both the Treasure Chest Keys and the Thought Can 1. So I definitely don't recommend... I definitely do still recommend having some money making. It's not necessary, depending on what you're doing, but this is a fairly difficult and impossible map, and I want to be extra safe. I am actually going to rush Super Monkey because purple thought power. The one thing I will say, this is important, Super Monkey, do not have him in range of FP's range. And not his placement, his range should not be inside FP's range. That may sound a little confusing, so it's going to be simpler when I actually place him. Oh, camera detection already. Do you have Time Machine? Maybe? You do, okay. That was a lucky guess on my part that Warrior P be actually a Time Machine. This is an app with camera detection. I need to get that straight away. Okay, well, that was dumb on my part. I got so lucky there that I remembered that Warrior P be had Time Machine equipped. Keep in mind, yeah, you don't be dumb like me when doing that. That was a pretty dumb mistake. I was able to fix it because I'm used to playing this game a lot, and I've developed somewhat not horrible micro. Time Machine's a nice epic trinket. It just resets the round if you lose. Only works once, but I can just, like, place the character quickly before you lose. And it keeps you alive and fixes one dumb mistake per game. It's pretty nice. It's not important to the strategy whatsoever, but it's a nice one to have if you mess up. Which, well, I did then. But beyond that, shouldn't be that big of a deal. Anyways, so, Super Monkey. This is the edge of PB's range, or FP's range. It's right at the water. So what we want to do, make sure Super Monkey's range, we want to place him, like, there. So that if you look at his range, even after you buy this range upgrade, well, I guess both, his range will not be touching her range. So while she is attacking, he will not be attacking. That's basically the point. It's not, like, the utmost necessity, but it is helpful because you want to maximize the fucking wandage. I mean, it depends. Truth be told, if you don't have treasure chest keys, this doesn't matter whatsoever. And the fact that both of my units have treasure chest keys, it also doesn't matter. But I'm going to do this strategy. It's as a guide, after all. I'm not just doing this for me. So in case you don't have two treasure chest keys, keep your characters apart. If you do have two treasure chest keys, like me, then, well, you don't have to do that. You can put all your characters right next to each other because it doesn't matter, like, at all. There's no greater odds if one has treasure chest keys than the other. So with my current setup, I could totally have Super Monkey right next to FP, right next to Flame Princess, but I'm not going to bother doing it because, you know, showing off what you can do. And it's really not that necessary. I mean, it's helpful, especially since she has Guru Meter in this case, but it shouldn't be that big of a deal. It shouldn't be that big of a threat. But we'll see. Purple balloons, by the way, that's where I went Disarming Charisma. In case you don't know, Disarming Charisma, any balloons get close to Super Monkey, they just take damage. If you can seize them. It doesn't work on camo balloons unless he has camo detection. Which is the whole issue of how weird camo balloons are in this game, but it doesn't matter. But yeah, so at this point, honestly, you can just upgrade Flame Princess. Nothing really interesting happens till around 42 is when the first orb comes, and you get to see all the things start popping up, the rewards. But that's not going to happen for a little while. The one thing is important to say, it only works Thought Can Wand. I think Treasure Chest Keys works for everything, but Thought Can Wand only works for your character's main attack. So for Flame Princess, only her fireballs would count for Thought Can Wand, her Heat Ray. Heat Ray might, but Fire Trap definitely would not. Same thing with Super Monkey's Disarming Charisma, probably wouldn't count. But his blasts, or air darts, or whatever you want to call them, whatever upgrades you have for him, that will count. It's just an important thing to keep in mind. It probably won't be that big of a deal, but just another thing to keep in mind, just in case. You're like, hey, I didn't get a wish orb, why didn't that happen? That's pretty much why. But yeah, you really shouldn't have too many issues with the strategy. This is obviously, although you can do this in extreme mode. You can. I'm not gonna say you can't. Don't do this on hard mode. If you can't beat extreme mode, once again, if you somehow have these items before you can beat extreme mode, you are either incredibly lucky or incredibly unlucky. But if you are in that situation, don't bother on hard mode. It's completely pointless. You'll get like 3 Moabs. You'll get nothing out of it. You can do it on extreme mode, but you get like a third, if not a quarter, as much Moab, so you just get like a quarter of the loot. It's not that good. In Popple mode really is the best because there's just the most Moabs. Like if you think about it, a Bad Balloon spawns into 2 ZMGs, 3 DETs. So that's, if you count the 3 DETs, that's 4. Then each ZMG ends up being 16 Moabs. 16 Moabs. Not to mention the 4 BFB layer, so that's 20, 21, 25. 25 layers. Each Bad Balloon is the equivalent of 25 separate Moab layer pops, which means 25 chances, or in a lot of cases, 25 items that you get thanks to Thought Can Wand. So it's a pretty big deal. But yeah, I mean, really at this point, you're just waiting through the game, waiting for the game to pass. I'm gonna upgrade Super Monkey now because Flame Princess is strong, but I'm not confident in it at all. Definitely not at all. Super Monkey, I have to admit, for Purple Balloons, Disarming Charisma, if he has cam protection, it is, as far as I am concerned, the only reliable way to pop Purple Balloons. Do not trust anything else. They will fail. Even Psy with his homing projectiles and things, it just doesn't work very well. Trust me, you want to be using, you 100% want to be using Disarming Charisma if Purple Balloons are an issue. Which for this strategy, since Flame Prince is meant to be your main damage, it will be. Disarming Charisma. I can't tell you how many times it saved me from the stupid purple balloons. It also pops LEDs, in case you're curious. it's not usually that important since we're using flame princes for this strategy, but it's a fun fact thing to keep in mind as well. Fortified Battling, yeah. So these towers could be very, this could end up quite poorly. We could end up facing a Fortified Battling, but I mean, I do have other items. Obviously, I'm gonna try to stick to these two towers doing damage, but I do have Lemon Hopes, and I have Benson Abadir, and I have Gumballed, which can't pop balloons, so their support. Support can definitely still be used, just the same reason why I have Cobras. They're not even in range, so they can't even do any damage. So support is definitely useful. If you are not at a stage where with two towers, even if you give them tons of good trinkets and things, they can pop all of the balloons, like they can solo, then you always have access to support. Lemon Hope, if you want to have Future Crystal or something like that on a different character, that can help. Money Making, Hunts and Abadir, Lemon Hope, Gumball. That's definitely the main support. But you can always use other things. Like, if need be, in certain situations, you can use PB for Regal Presence and that stuff. You just want to limit the amount of external damage sources. The amount of other damage sources, you want to limit that. I'm not going to bother with Sun God ability. I might keep the money on hand, but I don't think I'm going to bother for the time being. Simply because I don't think it's all that important. We are going to do our Lemon Hopes now. Hey, we're officially out here. As you can see, we just got an Uncommon Wish Orb. That is the wrong upgrade. I'm selling you, Cobra. I'm going to rebuy you. I don't really know why, but I am going to rebuy you. I meant to be upgrading Lemon Hope, because with Lemon Hope, I get to do that and that. What was I saying? Yeah, so as you did see there, we did get one Uncommon Wish Orb. It's not always super clear to tell, especially with Monkey Farm. They go away pretty quickly. But it's basically just a green circle on the screen. As you're seeing with more and more mobs coming, they're spawning cash crates or they're spawning lives. Hopefully, we're going to see a treasure chest key, because treasure chest keys, I always like it better. It actually spawns, like, the impalpable style chests on the ground, and it looks really cool. I'm not sure if we'll get to see it too well because of, well, Monkey Farmer. I might turn him off for the last couple of rounds, sell him, just to show you what it looks like when the item's on the ground. Especially since it's probably not going to be all that important, all that necessary. But yeah, it is a good thing to keep in mind. In fact, let's do it right now, before things get too crazy. I'm going to sell him for a second, ignore the Cobra money. I know it might be annoying if you have, I don't know, what's, I know it can bother you, but just ignore it for the time being. Okay, we're going to go install these mobs. In case you're curious, this is what's going to happen. They do despawn eventually, the item drops. I am warning you. They will despawn. Quite quickly. But there are some lives on the ground. There's an uncommon wish orb there you saw again that I could pick up. There's a rare wish orb there. If Monkey Farm is not here, really, it just, you just have to do it manually. The items are still there. They don't despawn or whatever. Are we dead? Well, that was the treasure chest. I would really prefer to continue this, because that was bad. So, I am going to continue this, because that bothers me. So that was a pretty bad situation. We did actually get pretty lucky there. We got some super rare wish orbs. The one thing this is one thing I was debating there. If you exit out of the game, you still keep your wish orbs that you get. If you lose, you still get them. So you don't actually necessarily need to be able to beat the BattdBloon. It's not actually necessary, but it is helpful. So let's just, you know what? I feel like getting some support, Hunts and Abadir, Gumball. Let's just get these two. This should make it much easier. This is what I'm saying. These towers, this is a hard map. I'm doing this on a fortified map. It makes it a lot harder. So realistically, do you want to continue? No, probably not. But the truth be told, with those treasure chest keys from the treasure chest keys, or with the treasure chest from the treasure chest keys, bit of a mouthful, you will get out of game coins. So you actually do get most of your rewards back anyways, so it's definitely not that big of a deal. But yeah, these guys. Oh, Gumball does. Okay, Gumball does one damage per hit. Hunts and Abadir does no damage, so he's better. But Gumball, even him, his one damage per hit, that won't really matter. But yeah, those treasure chests, they look like the impossible chest with the diamond, blue, and gold. Those are from the treasure chest keys. They're pretty cool. It's not always noticeable if they give you gems or those things. The one thing I will mention, because it is important to note, treasure chest keys. You will not see the gems or out-of-game gold you get when you beat the stage. It will not add to your total, because if you didn't know, you get coins, and if it's a new map, you get gems when you beat it. It will not show you the ones you get from treasure chest keys. Those are kept separate, kept hidden away. You will not see them. So yeah, just keep that in mind. It's also sometimes a little hard to tell what you get from the treasure chest, but you still get them, even if it doesn't show that you got them. Your numbers will still go up. This is not going super well. Fortified balloons, they are not something to joke about, and I'm a little nervous for the Babloon. So for the Babloon, I might do a little bit of preparation beforehand. We do have 40k, so I'm probably going to get Sun God just to be safe. Yeah, probably. Do I need it? Probably not, but I don't really feel like using another 1,000 coins. But yeah, this is basically farming. This is wish orb farming. You do this, you get gold, you get gems, you get wish orbs. It's great. I'm sure it's going to be more exciting to see the number at the end. That's always the part that's the most exciting. I know when I first got the the Thought Can wand. I actually made a video about it. I did like an epic wish orb opening, and I got it. If you watch that video, you'll see my expression. I was so excited. I had heard about it from the wiki. I knew what it meant. It was just a whole new level of the game. Massive progress. Getting Thought Can wand allows you to wish orb farming, and wish orb farming really is the thing that will make you progress through the game. So I'm going to buy this upgrade. I'm not going to use it straight away, because if it's not a 4-5 Babylon, I don't think I need to. But I'm going to have this prepared, because I might need to. If I do need to, this will 100% deal with the Babloon, because it's Sun God. It is fortified, okay, yeah. That sucks. Actually, I'm going to do some micro here. True Sun God ability, activate. Hopefully we can kill it. Well, Flame Princess is still in the radius, so she will walk on the other balloons. Otherwise, I'm actually going to sell her and buy her somewhere else. Okay, come on, Vengeful Sun God. You don't do this on a fortified map. I'm literally doing this because I want the collection as well. I'm not just doing this for the wish orbs. In fact, that's not the main reason. I want the collection. In most cases, do not do this on a fortified map, on a fortified Babloon. It's just not going to end well. We're still going to be able to pop this, right? We're still using the Vengeful Sun God. I thought he was OP. I've come to a number of times that he's really broken. Why is this not going so good? Okay, DTs are dead. Down to the ZMGs. We should be fine. As long as the Vengeful Sun God ability is in timeout, which I'm starting to get more and more nervous it will. It's a big ability cooldown, but still. We good? We're good. Treasure chests and everything. There were like three there. That's the one thing that's happened to me a couple times. Even with Monkey Farm, the second the game ends, anything on the screen, it despawns. You lose it. So, yeah, that's not very good. Five idols, what do you know? And a super rare wish orb. We've got a power up. This is also the final map in this collection, so we're getting an epic wish orb. Plus, we have... So currently, look at this. We have one. Keep that in mind. There's one. I believe, although we will get, I'm not sure if we got the maximum of 30 here. So we do, I'm going to collect this. This is our three, like, adventure crest. Adventure crest chest? Adventure chest. Might just be the adventure chest. It's an impoppable one, the diamond one. So we do get an epic rush orb. And if you look here, one of 26. So we didn't get the maximum. The maximum is 30. But as you can see, 26 wish orbs. If you look at that, I got 2. So I got 24 from one game of Impopple. I got 24 additional wish orbs. Yeah, it's a little bit nutty. This took me like less than 20 minutes. It's really good. Epic wish orb. Anything half decent? No? Well, that's too bad. I'll take another one of you. I don't know if I want it, but I'll take it anyways. I'm going for max collection, so I guess I probably could do some of those. Super rare wish orb. I believe we got at least one of these from the actual wish orb farming as well. I could probably use a third one of these. I use those a lot. Having a third one's not a bad idea. Yeah, we did get one super rare wish orb. You can get up to epics, I'm telling you, but super rares are much more common than an epic. I'll take a balloon trap, I guess. I don't know. I don't need most of this stuff. I'm sure a lot of you guys, newer players, are like, this is incredible, having all of these items, it's insane. It really is. If you have the chance to buy this, that's the main thing I say with saving gems. It's a common theme, save gems so you have at least 300. It's for the Thought Can wand. Treasure chest keys as well, but for the most part, it's for the Thought Can wand. If you have it, you go, it's really broken. Because look at this, this is like 4 or 5 rare wish orbs. 4 or 5 rare wish orbs, then I'm just like, yeah, I'll shard that and that and that. You can look at it, our total shard gains, ignoring the fact that I kept the super rare wish orb, which is worth 300. I'm sharding the rest of these. This is my personal recommendation. Depends on what stage of the game you're on, what you want. I was going max collection, but I have every single uncommon and common item in the game, so I'm just going to shard all of these. I also have all of the rares. So I literally have no need to keep these. I won't get anything good. I can get a few more shards. So if you're having a harder time with this, obviously you can go through the wish orbs, you'll get some bonus shards. But for the most part, you can just click the shard button with all 26 wish orbs. Most of them are going to be commons and uncommons, I'm not going to lie. But you will get quite a few rares and super rares, assuming you're not super unlucky. But that was that. We made a lot of shards. We got a lot of wish orbs. I believe if you look at our money account, it's up a decent amount as well. I want to say we started with 83,000, and I spent 1,000. I know we made like 150, but I'm pretty sure we made out-of-game coins and gems as well. So, you know, keep an eye out. You can go back to the beginning of the video to check if you want. But anyways, thank you all for watching. Please consider giving the video a like if you enjoyed. Subscribe and join the Purple Elephant Squad. It makes my day. It's super nice. I really do appreciate it. We're super close to 600, and I really can't wait. I want to reach 600 soon, so please, if you're new here, if you haven't subscribed yet, please do. And if you are, you could, you know, mention it to a friend or something. I don't know. It's always nice, too. But have a wonderful day. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Bye!